And now I'm like, ooh, that's a nice. So I knew going into horses that they were expensive and time consuming, but there were a few things about my life that have really changed over the years that I wasn't expecting when I bought a horse. For example, I check the weather pretty much every day. Now, prior to owning a horse, I didn't really care too much about the weather, but at this point, I'm checking the weather on a regular basis, and I'm trying to figure out, even down to the hour, approximately how hot it's going to get, especially in the summer, because I care about when I'm going to ride. If it might rain, I'm paying attention to how cold the temperature gets at night because I want to know what weight of a blanket to put on Fame now that he's clipped. I mean, these were all details and nuances about the weather that I honestly could have cared less about or had zero impact on me prior to owning a horse. My social life has also changed dramatically. Because I want to spend as much of my free time as possible with Fame, I find that I try to kind of cluster my social time with him. And so I spend a lot more time now with the girlfriends that I ride with than the girlfriends that I don't. And we've actually become very close. And it's just sort of a natural thing that happens because I'm here at the ranch all the time, I'm riding with Fame, and that's kind of been my priority. And my social life has had to kind of evolve and come along with that. And it's been great. I've met some really, really wonderful people. I'm super grateful for the friends and horses that I do have. I carry a knife now, like every single day. Again, something I never expected. I got nothing against knives. I just really never had a need for one. And now I'm like, ooh, that's a nice knife. I find myself checking out knives online. I've got a really cool fold-up pocket knife that I can stash in my pocket. And I've got a fixed blade knife that I carry on my belt when I go riding. And if you've watched any of my camping videos or my Highline video, you know that I have a knife for safety reasons in case I need to cut a horse free. But it also just proves to be helpful, like for opening feed bags. And then inevitably it's like, oh, I think I'm gonna cut this apple with my awesome knife. I have to admit that my car is extra disgusting now that I have a horse. The floorboards and the running boards on my truck are pretty much always covered in dirt. My husband sat in my truck one day and was like, what's that smell? And I realized it was me. It was my boots. And so I've started stashing my boots in the bed of my truck because, you know, you just get used to things sometimes, and some things maybe you shouldn't get used to. Keeping things clean in your car, just maybe I'm the only one that struggles with this, but seems a whole heck of a lot harder when you've got a horse. On the upside, I find myself having a much more meaningful purpose behind staying fit and for working out now that I ride more regularly. Having a strong core, having strong legs and glutes, having a strong back, all of that really helps in the saddle. And so when I am working out, well, first of all, I'm working out more. And then when I am working out, I'm really focused on what exercises can I do that will help me strengthen my legs, strengthen my core, strengthen my back. My priority is to be a better rider. And it helps me focus those workouts as opposed to just going, oh, I gotta work out because it's good for me. And it makes working out a lot more fun because I've got kind of that end goal of being a more fit rider in mind. My wardrobe has changed dramatically. I have a couple of outfits at this point that are nice outfits for a date night or for a special event. But pretty much everything else, all of the real estate in my closet has gotta be horse worthy. And so I've got a lot of jeans. I'm growing my boot collection. My shirts are all pretty much riding shirts. And anytime I'm gonna spend money on clothes, the first question is, well, could I ride in this? I wear hats now, which I never did before, mostly because I didn't like the constriction on my head and it made my forehead itchy. And so now I'm constantly in search of a comfortable hat. But when you're outside all the time, you know, you want to keep the sun out of your eyes and off of your face. Kind of helps keep the hair back when the wind's blowing around. So now hats have become just super important and functional, and I find myself wearing hats so much more. I think about spending and lump sums of cash in horse equivalent terms. A friend was talking about buying a car, and in my head I was thinking, what kind of horse could I get for that much money? Thinking about spending money on something for myself, I'm always thinking, that's the equivalent of a month's worth of training, my board, a bag of hay pellets. All of these pricing things now have been reduced to, well, what does that cost in terms of horse stuff? I drive a lot slower now than I used to, mostly because I've gotten so used to towing a trailer. And of course, when you drive a trailer, you drive a lot slower than you would otherwise. And so I kind of drive like a grandma, and I forget sometimes that I am not towing anything, so I don't need to be in the slow lane, just sort of force of habit. I also pay attention to like certain gas stations. I think, oh, could I pull in here with a horse trailer? Or just certain roads, like how hard would this be to drive with a trailer? I wonder. And of course, anytime I'm on the road and I see someone else towing horses, there's a really dorky part of me that wants to like go, hi, I have a horse too. I don't, but I want to. If you're a horse owner, I would love to know what unexpected changes to your life horses have brought. Let me know down in the comments below. And if you'd like to watch more videos about what it's like to have a horse, you can check them out right here.